It was not often that Mr. Wells left his house for very many hours with no one in it, period. During the day, Miss Black was these for most of the time, period. Miss Black could not be called his housekeeper as he himself kept watch on the stores and on the money spent. In fact, he bought most of the food, cleaning materials, and soon on his way home from the office and merely passed them to Miss Black to put away, period. No, Miss Black could not be given the high-sounding name of housekeeper, but neither could she be called the woman who did for him, period. She fell somewhere between these two high and low points. She was a daily help of the most valuable kind, and she looked after the house of Mr. Wells with as much care as she would have looked after her own, had sighed she had one of her own, period. But she had no house of her own, and in the evening she went off, and even Mr. Wells did not know where she went or what she did, period. During the day, therefore, his house was in good hands, period. In the evening, there was himself and there was his brother, period. Generally, they were both at home, for neither of them was much given to going out, period. They didn't like parties and they did not like the pictures, period. They did not care to pay high prices to see plays which, in their opinion, were generally not worth the money that had to be sent in the getting up to town and paying for a reasonable place, period. Neither of the men had married and neither had a regular girlfriend, period. Their evenings were, generally spent in the house, and it was the house that they both loved more than any other thing in the world, period. It was certainly a lovely little house, far enough away from the city to be almost in the country. It was peaceful and there were good views from the windows. From the outside, it looked in most ways much like the home of anyone with a reasonably well-paid position in the city, period. Few people ever stepped inside, but those who did were greatly surprised, for certainly the inside of the house was not in any way like the common run of houses, period. It was full of the most valuable thing and certainly placed and marked, period. What had been two living rooms had been made into one very large room in the form of the letter L, period. The room was white and as clean as if it had been in the hands of the painter that every day, period. Everything in the room was clearly a showpiece, something bought at a sale and for which a high price had to be paid, period. The pictures were old masters and the books were beautifully covered, period. The table and all other pieces had been carefully bought one by one as opportunity and money made such buying possible. It was such a room as one might except to find in one of the great houses built in a past age, but no one could possibly expect to see anything of the kind in such a place, period.